In this video, we'll walk you through the steps to prepare your fuse for printing. First, insert your fuse build chamber. The build chamber is a key component where the actual printing process takes place. The build chamber is designed to maintain optimal conditions for the SLS printing process, including temperature control, which ensures consistent printing results and prevents warping or improper sintering of the material. Using the slider on the touchscreen, open the door of your fuse printer. Press the button on the build chamber latch to unlock the latch. It will automatically spring open and stay raised. Stand in front of your build chamber so the front handle and plug holster are facing you. Lift the chamber using the two side handles. Place the bottom of the build chamber onto the lip of the print enclosure, then gently guide the chamber along the guide rails until it's fully inserted into the enclosure. Push down on the build chamber latch, pushing on the button to lock it into the closed position. The build chamber plug is the communication system between the build chamber and the printer. It helps the printer detect the presence of the chamber, know its assigned powder type, and communicate with the chamber's heating system and temperature detection. Print hours on a specific build chamber are also logged in order to alert you when standard maintenance should be performed. When your build chamber is outside of your fuse or sift, the build chamber plug should be inserted into the plug holster to protect the delicate pins. Now that you've inserted the chamber, move the build chamber plug from the holster straight into the build chamber socket until you hear a click to connect it to the printer. Be sure to seat the plug firmly to prevent air from leaking from the print enclosure. If everything is inserted and locked correctly, you should be able to close the printer door with ease. If you hit an obstruction using the door, check both your latch and your build chamber plug to ensure they're fully seated and locked. Before you load powder for the first time, make sure to register your powder credits. To load your powder credits, insert the powder credit card into the card reader. On the Fuse 1, this card reader is located under the top door just behind the IR sensor slot. On the Fuse 1 Plus 30 Watt, the card reader is located on the outside of the machine to the right of the touchscreen. Once you've inserted the card, the powder credit screen appears on the printer's touchscreen. The dialog box updates to show the new powder credit total. Next, it's time to load powder. While you may wish to load powder by emptying the contents of the jug directly into the fuse powder hopper, that is not recommended as it makes for a very messy process, and relying on your sift to manage your powder health is imperative. Instead, load the fresh powder into the fresh powder hopper on your sift. Use the fresh powder hopper lid to pour the contents of your powder jugs into the fresh powder hopper. The fresh powder hopper can hold approximately 8 to 9 kilograms of powder. Once your hopper is full, reinsert the fresh powder hopper lid over the opening. This ensures that debris and recycled powder do not enter the fresh powder hopper. Insert your powder cartridge into the cartridge drawer, ensuring the valve knife is in the open position. On your touchscreen, set the refresh rate to 100%. This ensures that only fresh powder is being dosed into the cartridge. Then press fill. Once the powder cartridge is full and dosing has stopped, pull out the cartridge door, close the valve knife, and remove the cartridge. Since the powder is 100% fresh, you can skip the mixing step at this time. Taking the cartridge to your fuse printer, lift the lid of the powder hopper, slot the cartridge valve into the opening with the blue valve handle facing you, and pull the valve knife to allow the powder to drop into the hopper. Leave the cartridge in place on top of the hopper for approximately 1 minute to let the plume of powder in the hopper settle. When ready, close the valve knife, remove the cartridge from the hopper, and close the lid before printing. Before starting a print, ensure that the hopper contains enough powder for the print to successfully complete. If the hopper dispenses all of its powder during the course of a print and has no more to pull from, the print will fail. Sensors in the powder hopper are used to prevent prints from being started without enough powder. For the most accuracy into how much powder is available for your print, Formlabs recommends a visual check. Open the hopper and look inside the wall. There are markings inside the hopper that show the current powder level. Compare the amount of powder in the hopper to the required amount determined by preform. If the powder available in the hopper is less than the powder required to complete the print, fill the hopper with additional powder. If the hopper is already filled above the 6 kg marker on the inside of the hopper, the cartridge may not be fully empty. When this happens, simply push the cartridge valve handle back in to close the cartridge. If any powder remains in the cartridge, retain it for future use. Before starting a print, the printer will prompt for certain maintenance procedures to be completed and will walk you through the necessary steps to complete them. For more detailed steps, scan the QR code to pull up the related support article. We'll cover these common maintenance procedures in another video. The Fuse One Plus 30 Watt has a nitrogen hookup for inert atmospheric printing. Nitrogen use is only required for specific Formlabs powders. If you will be using nitrogen during your printing process, please refer to our support article on using inert atmospheric control for the most current information on what materials can print with nitrogen, nitrogen sources, and how to enable this feature. Your Fuse series printer is now ready to print. Our next video will show you how to set up your Fuse build in preform for maximum efficiency.